Hey fellow animators, I'm Miloš Černý, and today I'm going to start a series about creating a full, four-legged quadruped rig in CAD. It will probably be just two parts. I will try to make them as short and on point as possible, because I don't want you to sit through 2 hours of video. After we finish, we will have this lovely 3D character ready for animation. The 3D model is free to download, created by artist Shiva3D and available on TurboSquid. There is a link below the video if you want to download it. I have made some changes to the model. It's not very visible, but red model is the original one and blue is edited by me. But I have only added some edge loops for back legs. And I remodeled the part between back legs and pelvis a bit to fix some overlapping geometry it had. Unfortunately, I am not able to give out this edited version for you to download because of the license limitations. You have to download it from TurboSquid and do the edits by yourself, or work with the unedited model, which is completely fine as well. The changes weren't that big anyways. The video will be sped up quite a bit. I will talk over stuff I did and slow down the more important parts for you, so you can see them better. So let's start by creating a cat parent. Zero it out, of course. And create a pelvis. I like to set up the z-axis of pelvis mostly by CAD units ratio value to keep the CAD unit scale correlated with model size. Now, when you are creating a rig, the most important part is the placement of pivots. Every time you place a bone, you watch where its pivot is and place it according to that. Dimensions are not that important, pivots are the key. Don't forget to rename the bones as you create them. Set up dimensions and create a leg. With legs, you start with positioning IK platform first. After that, we need to add one more bone for the leg because the creature has 4 joints in back legs, so one additional bone is needed. Next, position the ankle bone. Again, you watch where the pivot of the bone is placed. And set up the rest of the leg bones as well, with the same process. Use display as box option when you are not able to see through the bones to position them properly. After you are done with one leg, create another and it will copy and mirror all the properties of the first one automatically. Now rename them. With CAD, you should not rename the bones in the default 3ds Max name field, because as you can see, it will rename just that one bone. If you use CAD renaming, it will rename the whole bone chain at once. Now let's continue with spine. The important part here is that first you have to rotate the spine direction, not just the chest bone by itself. Select one bone of the spine, head to motion panel and click on sub-object button. It will display this blue line. And now, when you rotate it, it changes its direction. After that, rotate the chest bone as well and set number of spine bones to 1, because, well, we will not need more for this creature. Position the chest bone. Again, watch just the pivot, not the whole bone. Place it somewhere where front legs are going to be rotating. Now move spine. And put Edit Poly Modifier on chest bone to change position of its vertices to better reflect where the pivot is. The pivot will stay unaffected. Hit Convert to Edit Poly when done. Create another leg with chest bone selected. And again, start with setting up platform first. Add collar bone for this one. There is a checkbox for that in limb setup. And do the same process as with the back leg. Thank you. Add another leg when finished. Now let's move to the tail. Create one with pelvis selected. Three bones should be enough for this one. And just place the pivots where you think they should be. Creating rig is basically just thinking about where the points of rotations are and placing the bones accordingly. It's the main thing you have to figure out and learn, but it takes some practice, of course. Now we've had, there is another important part here. You can do head bone chain with two different approaches. Usually people just apply another spine, which is correct way as well, nothing wrong with that. But the thing is, with head as spine, you have limited control over the neck. You can animate just the head, and in some situations you will not be able to get the result you want, because you cannot animate neck bones separately. So what I like to do is to create head chain as a tail. With tail, you have control over each bone and can get the specific result you want. However, they are a bit harder to animate, because you animate 4 bones instead of 1. Sometimes there is no need for doing it this way, but for this model I decided to use tail. Don't forget to rename bones all the time. When you are done with the neck, select the last bone in the chain and click on Add Bone button. This will be our head. Again, most important part is the pivot. Now keep adding additional bones with head selected. We need jaw, nose, eyes and eyelids. For eye, align it to the eye geometry, so the pivots match. And rotate the bone so it matches the eye. When done, click on Copy Bone Settings, create another bone for left eye, and hit Paste as mirrored. It will position the bone exactly as it was for the right eye. Now add eyelids. It has the same pivot, so align it to the eye bone. Copy settings of the first eyelid and paste settings again, but not mirroring them. They rotate around the same y-axis, which we don't want, so rotate it by 180 degrees. Copy both of them to the other side. And as a last thing, add bone for the nose. You can add additional bones for whatever parts you want, not just the head, but the whole rig. I, however, decided that this is enough for this creature. And because we are artists, you can change those random bone colors to be a bit more appealing. I usually color the bones with the same ones in all the rigs. Green for all the right bones and blue for all the left ones, and rest usually shades of red, orange and yellow. One additional small thing I like to do when I am done with rig is to separate model and rig into layers to keep the scene clean and tidy. But that's an optional step and just something I like to do. So that's it for the first part. You can see the power of CAD rigging here. It took me less than half an hour to complete this rig and it has everything you need for the animation. I personally don't add gizmos for selecting bones because I don't use them and I select the bones directly, which works fine for me. In the next part, we will set up weights for the vertices to attach the model to the bones we created, in a process called skinning. I am Miloš Černý and thank you for watching. Soon I will start my own website, where I will be able to provide you with some additional materials for you to download. I am even planning to release some models with CAD rigs for free. So stick around if you are interested and spread the word. In the meantime, subscribe, share, like and comment. Thank you very much.